My father was an Adventist minister in a godforsaken mining camp called Canyon City. They called Canyon City the Deadwood of Oregon. And though I never visited the infamous town of Deadwood, I reckon the nickname was apt. They found gold in Canyon Creek just after the rush, and Canyon City sprung up not too long after that. My father was its first gospel man. He was there for 3 months before he got shot. In one of the last sermons my father gave before he was killed in the winter of 1891, he discussed what he called the fallacy of the absolute. Absolutes, he said, should never be applied to man, but are instead reserved for God himself and the devil himself. Man, my father preached, was a vessel for both good and evil, but never just one or the other. The righteous sometimes do evil, and the wicked sometimes do good. In the years after my father's murder, my sister's rape, and my mother's subsequent descent into madness, all at the hands of an outlaw gang led by a man named Frank Turnbull, I learned something. I learned that my father was right. We can't live a life of only good or only evil, but we can live a life only the devil would approve of. And I reckon that's bad enough.
Vengeance. Some folks call me that, yes. I'm assuming you know what it means. It means you want to kill him. The man who shot our pa.
I want to offer you an opportunity for revenge.
How do we know you're the real lady? I've heard tell of imposters swindling honest grieving folk out of their earnings.
That gun belonged to a man named Simon Luck. Those are his initials there above the trigger. When my family was attacked, Luck was one of the men who forced themselves on my little sister and took her innocence. He also helped string up my father's dead body after the outlaw Frank Turnbull shot him through a church window on Christmas Eve, 1891. Aside from Luck, whose throat I cut, and Turnbull himself, who took his own life, every member of the gang died at the wrath of that .42 caliber. Besides, I don't charge families for my services. Your earnings are safe.
Your pa was killed too?
Yes.
How old were you?
I was, 15, ma'am.
And still you avenged him.
I did what I felt was right. I still do. Every day. Redemption, vengeance, is my business.
You're damn good at it, too. I heard all about that shootout in Pal Butte, ma'am. I heard you shot Sagebrush Ben before he even cleared leather. Is that true?
Henry, please.
It's time we talk business. Your father was killed by a horse thief?
He was killed by the Dill Gang.
Gutless Virgil Dill?
That's a bastard.
Papers didn't mention Dill. You saw him?
The Dill Gang's been harassing the whole county for months. Only a matter of time before he came for our horses, too.
But did you actually see Virgil Dill pull the trigger? Did you see him at all?
I saw him. I saw Virgil Dill.
Tell me what happened.
It was near to midnight. I woke up to the dog barking. Pa was already up putting his boots on. He told me to stay put. Then he went outside. A couple minutes later, I heard two shots. So I went out and the horses were gone. Pa and the dog were lying dead in the dirt. And there was Dill, riding off with his gang.
How could you tell it was him in the dark?
Pa put an arc lamp over the pump house door last fall. Dill looked over his shoulder and right at me as he rode under that lamp. I saw his face clear as day.
I heard tell in town that Dill rode north, up into the hills.
Where exactly?
Can't be sure. Some folks think the wilderness around Strawberry Butte. You'd have to ask around.
I will.
Wicked flee when none pursueth.
Well, ma'am, I intend to pursueth.
Are you really gonna kill Virgil Dill?
That's the idea.
Then what?
Then I will return here with the possession of the deceased, as proof of my mission complete. Unless you'd prefer I bring back his corpse.
Dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves, but rather give place unto wrath. Romans 12:19.
Miss Appleyard, try to think of it this way. You are the Lord's dearly beloved, and I am wrath.
Scripture says violence only breeds more violence.
June.
No, she's right. I sign my life to one of bloodshed, but only to spare the turmoil of the undeserved. I will kill Virgil Dill so you do not have to.
But what about the law? Couldn't we go up to Enterprise and speak to Sheriff Blakely? He was the one Papa was always going on about, wasn't he, Henry? The one who ran all them vigilantes out of Crook County?
Even if Blakely cared, he couldn't do nothing. That wilderness is out of any law's jurisdiction.
I will not force my services onto you. If you'd rather seek help from the law, that is your right. And I wish you all the luck in the world.
What if you brought Dylan alive? Let the courts find him guilty.
Even if they did find him guilty.
They wouldn't. Not with this whole gang backing up his alibi.
Even if they did, he'd only get jail time. The only way Virgil Dill sees the end of the rope is if some vigilantes get after him, and that is the tall and short of what this woman is offering us.
So we just nod our heads and a man dies? You go off and kill him and drop his cadaver on our doorstep to do what with?
Feed him to the hogs.
Not before I piss on him first. Sorry, June. Ma'am.
Like I said, a possession of Dill's that he would not easily part with should suffice as proof of his demise.
This does not feel very Christian.
Miss Appleyard, did your father deserve to die?
No. No, he did not.
Well, Virgil Dill does. I'll make some inquiries in town about Dill's whereabouts. I have no doubt he's hid in the wilderness, but I may get a lead on where exactly the gang's hideout is. I intend to return here in 5 days' time. If I do not see you again within the week, I will more than likely be dead. Good day.
I'm sorry about my sister. She doesn't understand redemption the way you do.
Oh, I don't know. It could be she understands it better.
Let me come with you.
Excuse me?
Let me come with you on this mission to kill gutless Virgil Dill.
If you want to avenge your father's death yourself, go ahead. I have no qualm with your gumption.
I am no assassin.
Well, there it is.
But I can't fire a gun. Probably not as well as you, ma'am, but I can hold my own in a fight.
You ever been in a gunfight?
No.
You ever been shot at?
I have not.
Stay home.
But two guns are always
better
than...
You're not coming with me! Your courage is admirable, truly. But there's a difference between the courage it takes to fight and the courage it takes to admit you're afraid. One of them will get you killed.
Are you not afraid of death?
People fear that death is the greatest evil, but it may in fact be the greatest good.
I cannot tell if that quotation was meant as an answer to my question or not.
Well, most folks wouldn't have known it was a quotation at all, so you got a leg up on them. This homestead will need all the help it can get with your father gone.
We're a horse ranch, ma'am. Virgil Dill took everything we have.
Then stay and be a comfort to your siblings.
They hate me. They're only my half-brother and sister. Different mothers. I am my father's bastard. He took me in when my ma ran off. Gave me a home. Treated me just the same as the ones he raised. My pa was a good man, and June was right when she said he didn't deserve what he got. If I could be a part of avenging his death, if I, the bastard son, could do what his two spiteful and cowardly children could not, then I don't know. Maybe they wouldn't look at me like I was a clod of dirt anymore. Maybe they'd say I loved him just as much as they did.
The answer is no. You Tanner?
Yes, ma'am. Walsh Tanner. It's a pleasure to meet you, ma'am. I got your note, ma'am.
That's enough with the ma'ams, all right?
Oh, yes, ma'am. I I see what I
What have you got for me, Mr. Tanner?
Yes, righto. Let's see here. A man named Mississippi Hertel spent the night with a lady of the evening named Clarissa Coffey. Now, that was the night of the murder of Augustus Appleyard. Hertel's a member of the Dill Gang, you know.
You said Hertel's first name was Mississippi?
Well, I'm not convinced that is his Christian name, but that is what he is called, yes.
Go on.
Now, apparently Hertel got a little loose-lipped with that woman, Clarissa Coffey, regarding his gang and their whereabouts after what happened at the Appleyard place.
Where was Virgil Dill that night?
You'd have to ask Clarissa Coffey that. I asked her to meet you at the old woodshed tonight, just north of town.
What else do you know about Dill?
Gutless Virgil Dill? Well, I know he's an ornery snot, but more bark than bite, as they say. Likes books. His gang steals them.
They steal books?
That's right. Hold up Linden Library coaches. Steal the books. Used to, anyway. Seems they've moved on up to horses now.
Do you think Virgil Dill could have killed Gus Appleyard?
No, I don't suppose I do.
You've been a considerable help, Walsh. Our mutual acquaintance, Mr. Toombs, was inerrant in his vouching for you.
Well, I appreciate that, miss. Ma'am. Miss.
Clarissa Coffey?
Are you the one I'm supposed to talk to about that brush popper what I spent the night with?
That's right. I, got your name from a fella named Walsh Tanner.
Yeah, I know Walsh. What's he doing in all this?
He and I have a mutual acquaintance. That, mutual acquaintance suggested that Walsh might help me track down someone I'm looking for. Walsh led me to you.
He told me you'd be coming. Expected a man, though. What are you after that brush popper for?
He's a member of the Dill Gang, ma'am. In representation of a client, I intend to find the gang's hideout, where I will also find its outlaw leader and kill him.
You sure you ain't a man?
This brush popper tell you his name?
He goes by the name Mississippi.
He say if he's from Mississippi?
Klamath Falls, but Mississippi must have sounded like a better name.
What did you and he discuss?
We didn't discuss nothing. I took him to bed and he talked.
And what did he have to say?
He was bragging like they do. Said he was to sell a whole rag of ponies come morning. Had him hid back out of town somewhere. You're gonna get after that boy for some stole horses?
Not quite.
He is just a boy, you know. Stupid. The kind that get themselves killed for nothing.
Mississippi's not the one I intend to kill, ma'am.
Yeah, well, I bet he don't intend to die neither, but plans change.
Well, you're right about that.
If you want to know where the hideout is, I can't tell you.
You can't tell me, or you don't know.
Same thing.
Clarissa?
That is just about enough nosy questions, Nosy Rosie. Now let's see them hands. Up, up, up.
Mississippi Hertel?
Shut up.
I done good, Mississippi.
You done real good, baby.
I've got no truck with you, Hertel. It's Gutless Virgil Dill I'm after.
You ain't after no one no more, you hear? You're going after folks' days are done, Lady Vengeance.
Tell me where the gang is hiding.
Shit. Ford'll make me right-hand man for killing you.
Who's Ford?
That ain't the part of what he said you ought to be worried about.
Come on outside now. Slow-like.
You think Virgil Dill wouldn't sell you out, Hertel?
Shut up.
He'd give your ass up in a heartbeat.
Shut up, I said. You know what the hell you're talking about.
Mississippi?
Now start walking towards the river. Let's get this over with.
Mississippi!
Hey! The hell are you?
Don't kill him!
Keep back! Not another step. Over there.
Oh, god damn it, you bitch!
You alright, ma'am?
You goddamn...
Better now.
I reckon we ought to be going.
Not yet. I don't have what I came here for. Where's Dill hiding?
I ain't telling you nothing.
Tell me where Dill is, or I'll shoot her.
Ma'am?
Then do it. I ain't saying.
What?
Sorry, baby. I got obligations.
Mississippi!
I will kill her dead, Hertel.
Then do it!
Hey, Jesus!
Tell me where your gang is hiding, or the next bullet goes in her gut!
Ma'am, this ain't right.
Shut up!
Ma'am!
You're out of your goddamn mind.
Mississippi!
You've got 5 seconds, Hertel!
Ma'am, don't.
Baby, please, please don't do this!
Ma'am?
Baby!
Hertel!
Do it, bitch! Watch out!
Well, shit.
What the hell is the matter with you?
Hey, he had a knife.
I see that.
He was gonna stick
you. So you shot him.
That's right. To save you.
To save me.
That's right.
And instead of taking aim at the man's arm, or perhaps his leg, you fired off a load of 40 caliber, flat point lead, out the back of his skull?
It happened too fast. Would you prefer I let him stick
you? I preferred you let me handle it.
Hey, I saved your life. No two ways about it.
Holster that goddamn thing. Hey! And don't open your mouth again. Clarissa. Hey! Clarissa! I need you to tell me what you know right now. I am short of patience.
You were gonna shoot me.
Yeah, and Hertel was gonna let me.
Is he dead?
Very.
Okay. They got a camp. South of Prairie City in the Blue Mountains. He said it was along the Malheur River.
Did he mention Strawberry Butte?
Yes, I think so.
See how easy that was? Take that and get yourself cleaned up. Tell the authorities the killer went south. Understand?
I think I'm gonna vomit.
You never saw me or that asshole over there. Do you understand?
Yes.
Good.
So what do we do now?
I told you to keep your mouth shut.
Are we riding for the Blue Mountains?
We ain't doing anything. You're going home.
Oh, no way. I'm coming with you.
I told you the answer is no.
That was before I saved your life.
You saying you earned something back there?
I think so.
Yeah? Well, I don't.
I proved I can shoot.
Your target was a man's face less than 2 feet away.
Listen, you need my help. Whether you like that fact or not, it is still a fact. Now, I've spent my whole life hunting in them exact woods. I've explored up and down the Malheur River, and I know how to look after myself. Many an unfortunate traveler has gotten lost and died, or was ate up by mountain lions in the wilderness round Strawberry Butte. This ain't just about Virgil Dill. This is about making sure this thing gets done, and gets done right. You know hunting killers, I know hunting game. You know redemption, I know survival. Let me help you. I can help, you need my help. Now let me help.
Thank you.
why are we stopping?
This is where we leave the horses.
What? Why?
The terrain's too rough up ahead, or don't you already know that?
Well, crying in the mud. I can't leave my family's last horse out in the middle of nowhere.
I already spoke with the owner of that homestead over there. She's agreed to feed and look after him while we're gone.
Damn. You really do think of everything, don't you, ma'am?
I'd rather you not call me ma'am.
All right, then what's your name?
What?
What's your name? What should I call you?
I don't know. Not ma'am.
You want me to call you not ma'am?
No.
All right. Then what's your name? Why are you back?
I don't want to tell you.
Why not? Come on.
I just don't.
All right. Then, maybe I should call you Lady Vengeance?
No.
How about the lady? Ooh.
Ma'am is fine.
All right.
And, what should I call you?
You mean besides asshole?
Yeah.
My name is Buck, ma'am. Buck Appleyard. What?
Nothing.
What?
It's nothing.
Are you laughing at my name?
It sounds like something Mark Twain would have come up with. I'm Buck.
Mark Twain. You read Mark Twain?
Does that surprise you?
Seems everything about you surprises me.
Let's get moving.
After you, ma'am. Should we investigate?
I reckon.
I don't think that fellow's playing with a full deck of cards, if you catch my meaning.
You think he's gone loco?
What's that?
Crazy.
Well, look at him.
You goddamn unfeeling!
Sure as hell looks crazy to me. Got the mountain fever.
He's pissing angry, that's for sure.
Let's leave him be. Crazy folks will kill you for nothing.
Son of a motherless, syphilitic Roxborough whore!
Shit! Fellow's a damn wordsmith.
You monstrous contraption!
Is he saying all that to a rabbit trap?
You know, Buck? I think he is.
He really is low blow.
Loco.
Loco. He is loco.
You stupid thing! You rotten son of a bitchin' devil machine!
Let's go see what the problem is.
What? Can I talk to a guy with mountain fever?
What in the hell is mountain fever?
You know mountain fever. When someone spends too much time in the mountains and their cheese slides off their cracker. Happens to prospectors.
Does he look like a prospector to you?
No, but he looks like a trapper to me. Same difference.
A real trapper wouldn't abuse his traps.
They do if they've gone loco.
Still, he may have seen Dill in the area. We have to ask. Come on.
Excuse me?
Huh? Don't shoot! I am unarmed and unburdened with any items worthy of purloining. Unless you're in search of some slightly damaged animal traps or a case of prime beeswax pomade. And in regards to the latter, I could haggle with you, but not permit your absconding it outright.
I told you.
Speak earnestly, bandits. Do you intend to make off with my few possessions and leave me here dead? Or leave me here for dead? One of the two is preferable to me, but as the supplicant concedes into the ear of the Lord, it is ultimately your decision.
Listen, we're not gonna rob or hurt you, all right?
Well, that is a providence, ma'am, a true providence. For even before I had set foot off of the train, base villains had already removed from my coat pockets the only possessions of any value, both monetary and empirical. They also took my coat.
Put your damn arms down and quit talking like that.
Like what?
With more words than you need.
What an uncommonly picturesque thing to say. Will you permit me to write that down?
Who the hell are you? And what are you doing smacking your traps against a tree trunk?
Oh, you saw that intemperate display.
We figured you'd gone coco.
Loco.
Damn. I had it and I lost it. What is it again?
Loco.
Loco. Damn. Loco.
I have loco. Not gone loco. Unless you label my decision to abandon my comfortable home in the East for this godforsaken land of inopportunity as such. And you would not be erroneous to make such a claim.
You're from back east?
Yes, ma'am. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I am P.W. Foster Jr. of the Philadelphia Fosters. It is a pleasure to make your acquaintance, if it is true that you do not intend to burgle me, as you say.
The hell would we want with some bust rabbit traps and a case of hair goop? I'm Buck, by the way.
Hello, Buck. And your name, ma'am?
Not important. Listen, Foster. We're looking for someone who's been through these parts. We were wondering if you might have seen him.
I'm sorry to say, ma'am, that I cannot be even the slightest of help. I haven't seen a soul since I set foot in these hills. In truth, I'm horrifically lost. I have been for 6 days. My food supply ran out with startling speed, and these traps are useless at procuring anything but falling leaves, which carry little by way of nutrition, hence the reason for the tantrum you witnessed. What I'm trying to say, ma'am, is twofold. One, no, I have not seen the subject of your no doubt dauntless search. And two, do you have any food?
So what brung you out west, Mr. Foster?
Come again?
What brung you out west?
Ah, yes. Well, a broad, diverse multitude of factors, young Buck, but chiefly the desire to escape the clutches from drab and dour Philadelphia and seek personal fortune elsewhere. And where better to find excitement, intrigue, and adventure than in the Wild West? And so, with a case of my family's prime beeswax pomade, which my father insisted that I take and sell, I set out for Oregon to become an accomplished fur trapper.
It's pronounced Oregon.
Is it okay with you if I still pronounce it Oregon?
No.
So you come out west looking for adventure, huh?
An adventure I found, young buck. Although it was not the particular brand of adventure that I had read about. Even Mr. Mark Twain couldn't have prepared me for the perils that I endured when I planned to leave my home and rough it myself.
You like Mark Twain?
Hush now, young buck. To say that I merely like Mr. Twain is akin to saying that I like the very air in my lungs, or that I merely like the exotic construct of language itself. I love all of these things. I do not like them.
Well, me and the lady, we like him too.
Bully! Oh, simply bully. I am pleased to know that my compatriots are of the literate variety. Unlike the corrupt troglodytes with whom I shared a train to Baker, and who robbed me not long after my journey, and took from me the opal pin which once belonged to my late mother, God rest her soul.
Sons of bitches.
My thoughts exactly.
How do you know they couldn't read?
Only illiterates would treat the written word as monstrously as these wicked fiends.
What do you mean?
I mean that when these highwaymen commenced to rob me, they took one look at my case of books, in which there was a substantial number. And one proclaimed, "Books, books, I swear if I see one more book, I'm liable to have a conniption fit." To which the other replies, "Don't worry, we ain't in the book stealing business no more." And then they begin throwing each and every one of my books out the window of the moving train, the heathens.
They use the phrase book stealing business?
Well, that is correct. And after they tossed all of my books into oblivion for only the wolves to read, they then took from me my wallet, my coin purse, my hat, gloves, coat, eyeglasses, and finally, the irreplaceable opal pin which once belonged to my mother.
Damn, Mr. Foster, I'm sorry.
I then thought it lucky that the animal traps that I had brought with me had been stowed away elsewhere and had therefore not been pilfered from me. I know now that if they had been, I never would have embarked on this perilous escapade, which has proven disastrous in every possible way, with the exception of being acquainted with the two of you, of course.
When was it you were robbed?
This occurred Friday last.
And you left Baker for the wilderness that same day?
That is correct. Today marks the sixth day in this godforsaken forest.
You got something on your mind?
Just thinking of something Walsh Tanner told me. About the Dill Gang. He said they used to steal books.
Books? He said that?
Yeah. Did either of these fellas mention the name Virgil Dill?
No, ma'am, not that I recall.
You thinking these two might be part of Dill's group?
They said they used to be in the book stealing business. I never heard tell of any outlaw who stole books other than Virgil Dill.
How exactly does that help us?
Not sure. But it's a hell of a coincidence.
Have I heard correctly that the man you are in search of is an accomplice of the two wretched ogres who took my mother's opal pin?
It's possible.
Well, then I must join you.
What?
Great!
No. No. Mr. Foster, I'm sorry. That is not an option.
Why not? Those villains robbed me. They destroyed my personal property. It is only just that I aid however I can in their capture.
We're not looking to capture anyone.
What do you mean?
Virgil Dill shot my pa. When we find his sorry ass, the lady here is going to kill him.
My word, you two are assassins?
More or less.
I see.
But we were never gonna rob you. Remember that.
You all right, Mr. Foster?
Well,
You know something? That sounds like an adventure.
What?
Western justice. Superb! Simply superb. Oh, I must join you. You must allow it.
Look, Mr. Foster, it's really not possible. I work alone. I only let this one come along because he knows the area. He's more guide than partner.
Well, in that case, I also require your guidance as well, Buck. How much is your hourly rate?
What now?
How much are you charging this young lady for your services as an attendant?
Hold up. Now that ain't what I meant. This is a particular mission with a particular goal. Kill gutless Virgil Dill. We can't muddy it up with a mess of motives.
Should I be charging her?
Well, I have not been in the West long, and I can see that it is your home, and you undoubtedly know its customs and rituals but far better than I. But it occurs to me, outsider though I am, that if you intend to kill the leader of a gang of outlaws, that gang of outlaws would not allow...
God damn it! What the hell are you saying?
He's saying that you won't be able to kill Dill without killing his gang first.
Precisely. And, therefore, you would be forced to confront the rabblest vermin who made off with all of my earthly possessions save for some unfortunate animal traps and my case of family beeswax pomade.
How about this? You stay here, we'll leave you with some food, and after we kill Dill, we'll take your mother's pin back and return it to you. That way everybody gets what they want.
Your offer is reasonable as it is temptable, ma'am. But I must refuse. You see, I've suffered nothing but hardship out here in the West, but in truth, it pales in comparison to the suffering I experienced in Philadelphia. I am the last in a long line of Philadelphia Fosters, and it came to me to inherit our pomade fortune, which my father and father's father toiled so hard to build. It quickly became apparent to my family, as well as myself, that I completely lacked the leadership necessary, as well as financial acuity. So much so that my singularly money-minded father seemed to will the prolonging of his years to remain in control. And even so, I had wealth, promises, privilege, and still no happiness came to me. So I decided to light out for the territory, a decision that I and I alone had made for myself. And since then, I have made a promise that no one make a decision on my behalf without my consent. And therefore, I would like to hire the both of you.
Come again?
Buck, to be my guide in this land that has nearly robbed me of my sanity, and you, ma'am, to serve as wisdom and protection. Now, obviously, I do not have the money with me at present, but you have my word that you will receive payment in full if you allow us to combine our efforts to slay that murderous dragon Virgil Dill and retrieve my mother's opal pin.
Mr. Foster, you gotta understand. You see, the thing is, I can't just... I've always, oh, shit. How much money we talking?
Thank you. Yes, I'm awake.
Yes, ma'am.
I need you to break up that kindling.
It would be my honor, truly. How small?
We need as many bits of wood in this hole as we can fit.
Bully.
Why are you digging a hole for?
You fill the hole with kindling, you burn it down to coals. It's easier to cook on, it's just as warm. Not as noticeable as a tall flame and doesn't attract unwanted attention.
Won't keep animals away as good as a tall flame, though.
Should we be worried about animals?
I don't know. Depends if you're scared of a bear or not.
Bears? What about bears? I've seen no bears.
Foster's been here a week. He ain't seen any bears.
Well, it's not bears you gotta be worried about. It's a bear. Single. The Paiutes call him Toboga.
Ah, shit.
What?
Indian tall tales ain't worth fretting over.
Toboga is no tall tale.
No?
Nuh-uh. He's a big-ass bear, that's what he is. They say he lives in the old mines on Onion Creek, where the bones of generations past devoured make his bed, and a mountain of silver lays his pillow. They say if you are to hear his roar, it brings good fortune. But if you see his eyes, black and soulless as the smoke of a forest fire, it means certain death.
I have a question, young buck. How big is this toboggan bear, precisely?
His name is Toboga, and he's big as a stagecoach.
My word.
Bullshit.
Pray tell, what is the genus of this monstrosity?
The hell you say?
What type of bear is this, Tubrabug?
I reckon Toboga's a grizzly. My pa saw him.
Your pa told you he saw a bear as big as a stagecoach?
My pa did see a bear big as a stagecoach. He saw Toboga. Barely escaped with his life.
I don't dispute that your pa saw a big bear buck. What I take a qualm to is the claim that he saw this legendary, mind-dwelling, stagecoach-sized Indian hell bear you're describing.
Well, fooey on you, then.
I apologize.
Oh, you'll be apologizing, all right. When Toboga shows up and takes a piss on your teeny-weeny fire pit here.
So you're saying a regular-sized fire would keep this stagecoach-sized grizzly at bay?
Doesn't sound like much of a brute to me.
Oh, hell. I just brought up that fire stuff so I could talk about the bear in the first place.
So the size of our fire doesn't matter, then?
I guess not. Toboga does show up, we're up shit creek without a paddle no matter what.
Shit creek. Without a paddle. Oh, my word. That is exemplary. Oh, I must write that down.
You mind if I ask you a question?
You should be asleep. We'll reach Dill's camp tomorrow.
I won't be able to sleep if I don't ask.
Go ahead, then.
Why are you doing this?
Going after Virgil Dill?
Yes.
Because it is what I do?
I reckon that's a reason. Not really an explanation, though.
You didn't ask for an explanation.
Well, now I am. Explain it to me.
Like I told your half-sister, I offer people an opportunity. One that they can't get anywhere else.
Revenge.
That's part of it.
Revenge they don't have to lift a finger for.
That's the other part.
How long you been doing this?
Didn't you say a question? 4 years thereabouts.
And it all started with that fella Turnbull? When he killed your pa?
When he killed my pa, raped my sister, and drove my mother to the loony house.
Did you really kill the whole Turnbull gang? I mean, all of them? Must have been 12 men.
17. But I didn't get the whole gang, though. In truth, the only one I didn't get, number 17, was the worst of them all.
Frank Turnbull.
I guess it started when Simon Luck came back for more. Tried to take my sister a second time. And me. So I cut his throat. And I kept cutting until his head came off. And I realized then, watching that head roll across the floor, that the law, the courts, the judges, that shit would never be enough. They'd never do what really needed doing. It took me 3 years, but I found them all. The whole gang minus its leader. Shot him dead with Simon Luck's Colt Peacemaker. And then when I finally caught up with Turnbull, the miserable goddamn son of a bitch hanged himself. Knocked over a kerosene lamp doing it too. Nearly burnt downtown Canyon City to the ground. I had him, though. God damn it, I had him! I tracked him from Burns to Willow Creek, all the way up to Pendleton, and then finally Canyon City. Where it all started. Funny how things circle like that sometimes. I had him. And he did himself in before I could do it myself.
Maybe it's better that way.
What?
I just mean, well, shit, ma'am. You scared the man so bad, hunting him all over the state, that he put a rope around his neck. Now that's fear.
Cowardice is what it is.
Still, you made a coward out of the outlaw Frank Turnbull. Counts for something. At least the bastard's in hell now.
Yeah.
I still don't explain how you got from there to here, though. Why are you sitting with me at this campfire? Why are you helping me?
Don't mistake the killing of men as any sort of generosity, Buck.
What do you get out of it, then?
You know, earlier, when I said it is what I do, I should have said, it's all I know how to do. And when the Turnbull gang died for good, I was still filled with fire and torment. Hadn't been washed away like I thought it would. I'd killed 16 outlaws, and all I had to show for it was a quick draw and a disciplined trigger finger. I was hard, ornery. I was bound for hell. And that is when I met Lucas Grigg. Can I help you?
Yes, ma'am. I think you can.
Who's Lucas Grigg?
I'm getting to it! Lucas Grigg was the youngest of the Grigg boys. The four sons of H.L. Grigg, a wealthy Primeville cattleman and a widower. Now one day, the eldest of the Grigg boys, Travis, got into a dispute over a card game with an outlaw named Alvaro Montero Ibarra. Travis pulled his gun on Ibarra, and Ibarra shot him dead. The next day, the father, H.L., went into town to challenge the Mexican outlaw and avenge his son's death. Ibarra killed him too. The day after that, the second eldest son, John Grigg, challenged Ibarra again, but like his father and brother, he was no match for Ibarra's quick draw. Finally, the third son, Wyatt Grigg, went into town seeking redemption. Now, he just walked into a saloon and just started shooting. Hit Ibarra in the hand, taking off a couple fingers. But in all the commotion, he also shot and killed an innocent man and put a bullet in a saloon girl's leg. That leg had to be sawed off, and a mob hanged Wyatt Grigg that night. In less than a week, Lucas was the only Grigg left alive. So, having heard of my violent exploits, Lucas approached me, wanting to hire me on as an assassin to avenge the deaths of his father and three brothers. Having no source of income and no talent save gunslinging, I accepted. But it wasn't long before the story was relayed to Alvaro Ibarra, and the outlaw promptly fled town. So Lucas and I set to pursuing him.
Oh, why'd you let him come along?
Will you let me tell the damn story?
A few days later, we were right on his tail. We'd exchanged fire, and I knew
Ibarra
had only one bullet left in his six gun.
That's your last shot, Ibarra! You know it, and I know it. The only way I see it, you got two options. One, you shoot me, the kid here shoots you. Or two, you shoot him, I shoot you. There's no way out of this, you hear? So put the gun down and answer for your crimes against the Grigg family.
Don't shoot. Don't shoot. Do you know who I am? Because I know who you are. You're Alvaro Ibarra. Well, Mr. Ibarra, my name is Lucas Grigg. You shot and killed my father, H.L. Grigg, as well as my brothers, John and Travis. My brother Wyatt's the one that took that thumb and pointer finger off your right hand, remember? He was hanged after he tried to kill you, so the way I reckon it, you can take credit for his death, too. I wanted to thank you, Mr. Ibarra. That's all this is about. I wanted to come find you and shake your hand and thank you for what you've done.
Thank you.
For freeing me from those miserable sacks of shit. You see, sir, my mother died at childbirth. My birth. And they, my father and my brothers, they said it was my fault. They hated me. And by God, I hated them. But then the Lord sent you. He sent you to prove that they were wrong. He sent you to kill them. So thank you, sir. Thank you. Can I? Thank you.
Son of a bitch!
Help me.
No.
And that's that.
What do you mean, that's that? What's what? That can't be the end.
Well, it is, more or less.
More or less. Shit. What happened next? Were you okay?
I'm alive, ain't I?
Wait, so you're telling me the Mexican outlaw you were fixing to kill saved your life?
Yep.
Why?
Because he understood me. Or at least he understood what my purpose was. He couldn't understand Lucas Grigg. He couldn't figure him out. To Ibarra, I served an important function. I was an assassin. Lucas had no function, no purpose. And because of that, he got killed.
So you're telling me Lucas Grigg was just using you to get to Ibarra to thank him? You understand how crazy that sounds.
You're the one going on earlier about a giant Indian grizzly bear named Tobias.
God damn it, you can't just tell a story and not finish it, and his name is Toboga.
I did finish it.
Well, some goddamn ending. That's that.
What else do you want to know?
What happened to Ibarra? Why did you decide to still be an assassin after that shit show? And what in the hell did that story have to do with anything?
Alvaro became a good friend. He used to accompany me on missions, but he never got to be too good of a shot with his left hand. He still helps out, though. He reads the paper, looking for folks who sound like they could use my services. That's how I found you.
Wait. He's your friend? Your sidekick? You were gonna kill the man!
Exactly.
You were the most puzzling woman I ever met.
And as to your second question, the only problem with that mission was Lucas Grigg. Understand? I found Ibarra just fine. I had him. If Lucas hadn't done what he did, Ibarra would be dead. And that's why I'm still an assassin. Because villains can evade the law, and they can evade the Lord God himself, but they cannot, they will not, evade me. That's how I got from there to here, Buck. That's what my story had to do with. You want to know why I'm sitting at this campfire with a pissant horse rancher's bastard and a loudmouth Philadelphia dandy? It's because tomorrow, rain or shine, gutless Virgil Dill is gonna die. I'm gonna kill the son of a bitch because that is my function. And I will come one short goddamn step closer to figuring out why the hell I'm still alive. Time to get some sleep. We'll reach Strawberry Butte in the morning.
had a dream last night that I was 11 years old.
I had a dream last night that I was kept awake all night by your ripsaw snoring.
Well, I was asleep, Buck. I can neither be aware nor control my faculties when I slumber.
Tell us about your dream, Foster.
I was 11 years old.
Run, Peedum! Run!
Sure, I'll give you that. I had a dream once, though, about a half fish, half antelope. So I was fishing on the Crooked River, right, in the dream. And I get a bite, and I start pulling on the line. And at the end of the line comes out an antelope. And I think, that's not real, you know, because clearly. And then as soon as I thought that, just like I was in control or something, the back half comes out a fish, as it should be. Like half a trout, you know? So I take it home. Can't figure out how to mount the damn thing. Had a nice set of horns, though.
Quiet.
What, you hear something?
Quiet.
Lord, that's him. That's Virgil Dill.
And those are the two cretins that stole my mother's opal pin.
You sure that's Dill?
That's him, all right. I'd recognize those boots anywhere. Look at all them fancy rings.
But where's the rest?
Huh?
We're looking at three men. There's 12 in the Dill gang, excluding Dill. Where's the rest?
I reckon it's an ambush situation?
They left him behind.
What?
His gang. I think they left him. This was their camp. I'd say they left not half an hour ago.
You're saying that the Dill gang left their namesake? Oh, malicious.
You really think they could have dropped him?
Him and them other two, by the looks of it. Pack must have a new top dog.
And who do you think that is?
Doesn't matter. We ain't after the gang, we're after Dill. And it looks like we just found him.
So what now?
I can hit all three from here.
Hold up now. That ain't how this plays out.
Oh? And why not?
He needs to see me. Me. You can do the shooting, I won't get in your way. But he needs to know what he's dying for.
Buck, when the villain arrives in hell, he will know why he is there.
Screw hell. He needs to know now. He needs to know that killing my pa was what did him in.
Fine. But I'll need your help. Both of you.
Well, it was adventure you asked for, PW. It's adventure you found. My word.
Virgil.
Hey, Virgil.
The hell you want?
What's the plan?
There isn't any plan, you dumb bastard.
Well, what do we do next?
Do whatever you want.
Where do we go?
Go wherever the hell you want. I don't care. Where's Madeline?
I think she went to... you know.
What?
To do a... duty.
A duty.
What's the plan?
Virgil says there ain't no plan.
Ain't no plan? Virgil, why are there no plan?
Jesus Christ!
I got it! We'll head back up into Ironside to meet up with Mississippi. I bet he got like $500 for them Apple Yard horses.
If Mississippi Hertel had any brains, he would have run off with that money first chance he got.
You saying he cheated us?
Probably not. He likes Ford too much.
Well, we don't.
Yeah, Virgil.
We don't like Ford at all. That's why we stuck with you.
That's why you two are dumber than a box of rocks.
You know what, Virgil Dill? You're a real asshole!
Oh, good God Almighty.
Come on out!
Remember me, jackass?
Wait. Just wait a minute. This is all wrong.
Buck Appleyard?
Yes, ma'am.
Just hold on a minute.
Is this the man you saw fleeing your property after the murder of your father, Augustus Appleyard?
You got this all wrong!
That's him. That's gutless Virgil Dill.
You don't understand. This is all wrong.
Is your name Virgil Dill?
Ma'am, there's no need
Is your name Virgil Dill?
Yes, damn it, but...
On behalf of Buck Appleyard
damn it, just
and
listen.
The rest of the Appleyard family.
I'm not the one you're after.
For your crimes committed against
no,
them.
Please stop. Please
I deliver
stop.
You to your fiery judgment.
Frank Turnbull's alive.
What did you say? What did you just say?
Frank Turnbull, he's alive.
You vile sack of gutter trash!
He's lying, ma'am.
I know he's lying!
No, I am not! I am not lying! Frank Turnbull is alive.
Shut up.
I know where he is. I swear on my mother's life.
Shut your
mouth!
Don't listen to him, ma'am. Shit. He's lying. He's just trying to save his own worthless neck.
No, I'm not lying. It's the truth.
You
please,
goddamn!
Listen.
Stop!
Then do it! You do it or I will!
Just wait a minute!
No! No more waiting! Kill the son of a bitch! Kill him now!
I
your paw, boy. Don't you talk to me, you shitheel! I'll blow your face out the back of your face!
Oh, God damn it! Stop!
Turnbull's alive. He killed your paw.
Turnbull killed her paw!
No, God damn it! Your paw! Gus Appleyard, your paw and your dog!
You're a gutless liar, Virgil Till!
Frank Turnbull's dead!
No, he isn't.
Frank Turnbull hanged himself in Canyon City 5 years ago!
That's what he wanted you to think.
I know who you are, Lady Vengeance. I know what he did to you. I know what you planned on doing to him. He faked it. The whole thing.
How the hell do you know that?
He told me about it. He's in the gang, the Dill Gang. He goes by the name Sam Ford now, but it's him. One night he got pissed drunk, told us all about it, bragged about it.
Ma'am, please kill this
Wait!
Piece of...
Bragged about what?
About how he did it. How he tricked you. Said he killed a man in Canyon City near his height and shape. Swapped clothes with him. Put his spectacles on him, his bolo tie, belt buckle, rings, even his damn boots. And he hung the corpse up from the rafters, set fire to the place, so when they found the body, they'd think it was him.
Turnbull bragged about it to all of us. How he pulled a fast one on Lady Vengeance. When a fella in the gang asked why he didn't just kill her, Turnbull beat the ever-loving piss out of him. You got him whooped, man. That's for damn sure. You got him whooped. But he's alive, and he's in charge of my gang.
Why is that?
He stole it from me.
Oh, Jesus, Mary Joseph! Oh, yeah. I'm dead! Oh, I'm dead! Oh, good God! I gotta put it back.
The hell are you? Where's my brother? Where's Rascal?
He's dead.
Oh, damn it! You killed my brother! Oh! Damn bitch, killed Rascal!
I need you to answer some questions for me.
Go to hell!
If you answer my questions, I'll make it worth your while.
You killed my brother, and you put a bullet in my side. I ain't saying shit to you, you old bitch.
You see that man there? That man's name is P.W. Foster Jr. He's the best doctor in the state of Oregon. You tell me what I want to know, and the doctor here will patch you up. On top of that, I'll give you a shiny coin piece for your troubles.
You going to give me a coin piece?
You have my word.
Your word too, Doc! You want to patch up this here hole in my side?
Yes. You have my word, son.
You look kind of familiar, Doc. Ain't I seen you someplace before?
Only if you, sir, are a reader of many fine medical journals, most of which have my photograph featured therein.
Oh. Okay. All right. What you want to know?
You remember the Dill Gang, Mr. Kirby?
I was.
till this morning.
What happened this morning?
Gang took a vote. Kicked Dill out and elected a new head man.
Who won?
A fella named Sam Ford.
That his real name?
No, ma'am, it ain't.
What's Sam Ford's real name?
Turnbull.
This vote, was it Ford's idea?
Yes, ma'am. See, Ford's been the real leader of the Dill gang going on like 2 years now. Now, Dill was angry at Ford about killing that horse rancher, Appleyard? You want to go back to Robin Linden libraries, like in the old days.
So you're telling me Dill didn't kill the horse rancher?
No, ma'am. That was Ford. He killed his dog, too.
See? I told you, Christ's sake, why would I want to kill a dog? I love dogs. Turnbull's the one who hates them.
That's true. I once saw this sumbitch shoot the ears off a basset hound.
So you're telling me Virgil Dill ain't the leader of the Dill gang?
Ford put it like this. Virgil Dill couldn't lead beer out of a bunghole. The gang's got Dill's name on it, but, Ford calls the shots.
Why'd you and your brother stick with Dill after the vote?
We don't like Ford too much. Roscoe asked him once why he didn't just kill you. Ford kicked the piss out of him. I mean, we don't like Dill too much either, but, oh well.
Don't like stealing books?
There ain't no money in books.
There's value in knowledge, Enoch. You remember that.
Oh, shut up. Oh, God damn. Oh, my gut hurts. Oh, God. Doc, I think I feel the bullet up in there. It's tearing up my inner something fierce.
You've been a big help, Mr. Kirby. Much obliged.
Yep. Now, about that coin piece you promised me. What are we talking, like, silver or, gold?
Lead.
Jesus Christ.
Watch him. Ma'am? You all right, ma'am?
I thought he was dead for 5 years.
I know.
I've been trying for so long to make up for letting Frank Turnbull escape my wrath. And all this time, he was... shit. I killed a lot of folks.
They deserved it, though.
That ain't the point, Buck. Ed Bayless, Abigail Haggerty, Sagebrush Ben, Stanton Cree, all the others were all killers. They deserved to die. That ain't why I killed him. I killed him for me. I wasn't gonna kill Virgil Dill for you, Buck. Or for June or Henry or anybody else but myself.
Still the right thing to do.
Even if he didn't shoot your paw?
I don't mean Dill. I mean what you do. It's still right. It's still justice.
can only play God for so long.
Then play God for just a little while longer. And let's go get the man who shot your pa. And mine. Let's go kill Frank Turnbull.
I can't ask you to come with me.
Then don't.
It's a whole gang of killers, Buck.
Well, reason with them. Maybe they'll hand Turnbull over. Like you said, it's not the gang we're after.
And if they don't want to give him up?
Then you'll need all the help you can get.
You.
What?
You're gonna lead us to Turnbull.
What?
In return, I won't shoot you. And when Turnbull is dead, you can reclaim your gang.
To hell with the gang. I don't want them.
Good. Then if they refuse to cooperate, you can help us kill them.
What now?
Foster.
Ma'am?
Buck Dill and I are going to find the outlaw Frank Turnbull, and we're gonna kill him deader than hell. You in?
Ma'am, it would be my...
No time. Yes or no?
Well, I'll be damned. We're a quartet!
Ford! Hey, Ford! Ford! It's Dill. She's got him. He told her everything. About you? She knows you're alive.
Take a breath, for Christ's sake. What now?
The lady? Lady Vengeance? She knows. She's coming.
Say that again.
She's right behind us. She's coming. She's coming for you.
You positive?
It's her, all right. She knows. Dill squealed like a stuck pig.
Let her come. Let's kill the dumb broad. I mean, we outnumber her 8-1. Hell's bells, I take those odds.
She's got help.
How many?
Two.
Well, shit, let's send them all to their graves.
Yeah.
Come on, yeah. Sam, let's finish the bitch off.
Just shut up and let me think a minute.
For Christ's sake, what's there to think about? We got more men, we got more guns.
Just give me a minute, goddammit.
She's
damn
just
it.
A stupid on, little girl.
Sam, just
she's
need
looking
a...
for a fight. Let's
I
give her
said
a fight.
Give her a fight.
Let's finish her off.
I said give me a minute. God damn it. Everybody shut your goddamn mouths or you're dead, you hear? Madeline. These two that was with her, they look like gunslingers?
No, sir. One was the Appleyard boy, the bastard. The other one was a big, fruity-looking sumbitch.
Thanks for coming back to us, darling.
Oh, I was only gonna stick with Dill till I got a chance to cut his throat and take all them pretty rings anyway.
For this, I'm gonna get you all the pretty rings you want. You hear, darling? All right, shitheads. Here's how we're doing this.
Is this really necessary?
Yes.
But I'm not going anywhere.
Well, you know, Dill, for some reason I don't trust you.
All right, look. I'm not saying you should trust me, even though you should. I'm just saying I'm not gonna try anything because I'd rather not get shot.
You really are gutless, aren't you?
If you call not wanting to die gutless, then yes, I am. If you call not wanting to live by some outdated frontier code a sign of cowardice, then fine, I accept. Cowards stay alive.
Glad you admitted it, at least.
Not all of us are willing to live by the sword and die by the sword, Lady Vengeance. We can't all be high desert drifters. Some of us have to pick up the pieces when people like you shoot the world to shit.
What the hell do you do to pick up the pieces? Steal books?
Just like a desperado to mock the gift of reading.
Hey, she likes reading. She's a Mark Twain fan.
Is that true?
Who doesn't like Mark Twain?
People who can't read tend to not enjoy him very much. That is to say, most of the people I spend my time with.
Well, Bill, you're in the company of readers now, by God.
I must say, Mr. Dill, your collection of literature reflects what seems to me a remarkably refined palate. Dumas, Sheridan, Swift, Hawthorne, my word.
Well, thank you, Mr. Foster. And I must say that your impressive vocabulary is mighty refreshing, sir.
Likewise, Mr. Dill. Likewise. Oh, Cervantes! Oh, bully! Simply bully!
What book is that?
This here, young buck, is The Ingenious Gentleman Don Quixote de la Mancha by Miguel de Cervantes.
Ooh. What's it about?
It's about a fella who reads so many books he goes insane.
That sounds a tad familiar, don't it, Bill?
And he decides to venture off into the wilderness to battle evildoers and right wrongs. That also sounds a bit familiar, don't it, ma'am? It's my favorite book.
That's an exemplary choice, Mr. Dill. Although if I'd have to pinpoint a favorite of my own, it'd have to be Robinson Crusoe.
What about you, ma'am? What's your favorite?
Shut up.
Got it?
Say, how long have you and your gang been using this butte as a hideout?
Oh, about a year or so, I guess.
And you ever hear tell of any bears in the area?
Oh, Jesus.
I'm sure there are bears around here. Probably.
What? You ever seen any?
Yeah, Dill, you ever see any stagecoach-sized grizzly bears in your travels?
Hey, we was having a conversation.
Well, quit! It's best not to get too friendly with this one. He's a snake.
No offense intended, I'm sure.
I didn't say that.
You know what? I don't understand what your big goddamn problem is with me. I ain't kill your paw. I ain't kill his paw. I've never killed anybody's paw. Why do I have to be chained up?
Because you're a gutless yellow turd. Now shut up!
Great hearts, my dear master, should be patient in misfortune as well as joyful in prosperity. And this I judge from myself. For if I was merry when I was governor, now that I am a squire on foot, I am not sad. For I have heard tell that fortune, as they call her, is a drunken and capricious woman, and worse still, blind. And so she doesn't see what she's doing, and doesn't know whom she is casting down or raising up.
Hold it! You try it, you die. We got guns on you from 8 different directions. You killed Eye Patch, boss. 7 different directions.
Where you at, Frank?
Toss them guns, both of you. Toss them or die.
Hello, Rosemary.
Frank.
You know, I thought you'd be happier to see me.
Oh, just you wait. When you're lying face down in the dirt with a bullet in your brain, I'll be grinning like a lunatic.
Big talk. You think I'm scared of you, girl?
I know you are. Sam Ford. Jesus. Virgil Dill ain't the gutless one here. You are.
You gotta admit I licked you. Pretty good idea, huh? Put my boots on a dead man.
You'd rather pretend you'd killed yourself than face me. You're spineless, Frank. You're a goddamn worm!
Got some mouth on you. Makes a man wonder what kind of things you can do with it.
You're a piece of shit, Frank! I swear to God Almighty, I'm gonna kill you!
I don't think so, sugar.
Hello, Virgil.
So you the bastard? What's the matter? Ain't got nothing to say? Come on, boy. Curse me. Spit on me. You know what I did to the man who killed my pa? I cut his eyes out. You wanna do that to me? Huh? The bastard's a mute!
Probably a retard.
Ah, shit, Rosemary. I expected a better team of assassins from you. All you got here so far is a chained up coward, a mute retard, and a...
Whatever the hell this is.
What's he supposed to be, big boy? Aw, shit, another retard!
I, sir, am P.W. Foster, Jr. of the Philadelphia Fosters. And I, sir, am a trapper.
You don't look like much of a trapper to me, P.W. You look more like a sissy Eastern mama's boy. What the hell kind of shit you trap anyway, huh, Tubby? Chocolate cakes and pumpkin pie?
Mr. Foster. Hey, it's me, sir. It's Buck.
Young Buck.
Hey, that's right. That's me. Oh my God, Mr. Foster, that was incredible what you done. That was incredible.
I trapped him.
Goddamn right you did. Goddamn right.
The old boy.
What's it? What is it?
Mother. This opal pin hasn't been shot off.
No, sir. No, it's right here on your shirt.
Put it in my hand. Oh, fuck. This was...
What's it?
This was quite the adventure.
Hello, Frank.
Rosemary.
I guess my team of assassins was more... what's the word? Formidable than you thought.
I guess so.
Especially my friend Mr. Foster.
You're gonna have to speak up. This thing's closed over my ears.
Are you ready, Frank?
Go to hell.
All right. Frank Turnbull, on behalf of Buck Appleyard and the rest of the Appleyard family, for the crimes you committed against them not but 4 days ago, and on behalf of myself, Rosemary Faith Cavanaugh, for the crimes you committed against me and my family on Christmas Eve in the year 1891, I hereby deliver you to your fiery judgment.
Wait.
It's time, Buck. It's the end.
Not yet. Beg.
What?
Buck?
No. I want him to beg.
Sorry to disappoint, bud. There ain't no way in hell.
Ah! Gee! Oh, God!
Buck, you don't need to do this!
Yes, I do.
Ah, shit! My leg, God damn it!
Beg.
No!
Ah,
Jesus Christ!
Ah! You goddamn pissant bastard, some bitch!
Beg!
Buck!
Beg!
Ah! Please, alright? Please! Please don't do this! Please stop! Please! For God's sake, please!
It's time, Buck.
This can't be all there is.
What can't?
This? This feeling? Like I'm missing a part of me I need? Like I'm missing an arm, or my lungs, or my head? Like I'll never get it back.
You won't.
What?
I'm sorry, Buck, but you won't. You won't ever get it back. All you can do now is make sure the rest of you doesn't leave too. That's all.
What do you think killing him will do? Fix you?
Maybe.
Well, I don't think you need fixing. I know why you're still alive, ma'am. It's because there's more out there for you. More than this.
For you, there is. Not for me.
For both of us. For all of us. This shit won't ever make you whole. It's what you just said. But it will tear you apart.
Oh, shit. My legs. God damn it.
Please don't let yourself get torn apart, Rosemary.
What was that?
Some sort of animal?
A big animal by the sound of it.
A big animal.
Don't you say it. Don't.
Hey, I got a feeling we need to be getting out of here.
To Boga.
I told you not to say it.
Did you hear me? I said I think we should be leaving.
Damn.
Oh, I knew it!
Go! 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 Go!
I heard a whispered name across a desert plain. I thought it was your voice. I smelled a flower scent. But the wind blew it away. I saw your flaxen hair. You told me to beware, but still I came your way. You said you lived a life not fit for love. I tried to give my heart, but you were not done. Ooh. I heard a rifle shot rings out in the dark and slowly fades away. I smelled a copper tinge, clothes that had been singed, and I knew not what to say. I saw your reddened hair, your body lying there, never see another day. You said you lived a life not fit for love. Ooh. I tried to give my heart, but you were not done. Desert plain, and I thought it was your voice. I smelled a flower scent wafting violet, but the wind blew it away.